On this episode, we discuss the industry sales growth numbers, labor shortages, and the pro AV gender gap. These stories and more on AV Week.
The network for the AV industry.
What are you listening to?
This
is AV.
This is AV Nation.
This is AV Nation.
This is AV Week, episode 524, recorded September 3rd, 2021. Where do we go from here?
Support for AV Nation is brought to you by
Extron, industry-leading technology backed by world-class support.
And by Vadio, a leading manufacturer of professional PTZ cameras, Pro AV solutions, and UCC integration systems.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to another episode of AV Week, your source for news and information in the AV industry. My name is George Stucker. I'm sitting in for Tim Albright today, who is at Cedia. Thanks for joining us. Today, we're going to talk about some hot topics in the AV industry. And to join me and help get through all of those is two people who I haven't seen in quite a long time, and I can't wait to talk to them. First off is Victoria Ferrari. She is Senior Design Consultant at Conference Technologies Incorporated. Good to see you.
Hey, good to see you too, George.
Yeah, how are you holding up in this remote world?
Oh, it's awesome. Living the dream, man.
And of course, someone who's been doing the remote world for longer than probably most of us even knew what it was is the Rich Fragosa. He is owner of Fragosa Design, or as the rest of the world knows him, Uncle Richie. Good to see you, sir.
Good to see you too. Mellow West Coast greetings, actually on the AV Week side. So I think I'm going for the trifecta this month. So I've got this Resi and of course with my partner Steve Greenblatt, the State of Control. So always good to be on this one. I like being able to get my commercial chop time in.
Do you get a little like trophy for that? Is it like the Triple Crown?
It is. You know, it is the Triple Crown of AV. Exactly.
All in 1 month, right?
The hat trick.
That's it.
Yeah, the hat trick. There you go. We don't throw hats. We got nothing there. All right, well, we'll move on to the stories here. The first one up here is Avixa. It says AV sales growth remains strong despite rising Delta virus. This comes to us from AV Network, and it's dissecting Avixa's latest Pro AV Business Index. All right, so the skinny on the longer article is that sales are up. Especially in June, so it was covering the June, July, August region, but they were down from July. So June down, July up, not by much, but they talk a lot about the fact that we're slowing down and the concern for what comes in August and September. Now, obviously, we're recording this in early September, so we should hear those August numbers soon. Rich, I'm going to start with you. We saw a huge influx of work, especially residential, at the sort of midpoint of the pandemic. Lots of people wanting to gussy up the house, make it more livable, do the luxuries that they probably put off for a while. What are your thoughts on this sort of downturn, however slight it might be? Do you think this is a forbearance of something coming, or do you think we've really got our hooks in and it's just going to come back once school starts?
It's all coming down to supply chain. You know, this is... We're starting to see, at the beginning of the year, there was warnings that there was going to be supply chain issues, but the model numbers and kind of the existing stock was carrying through up until, you know, they're talking about June. It was fiscal year end for a lot of companies. So you hit that fiscal year end, sales always tend to kick in right at that very end. Budgets are being spent. They've got to get it through. And so at that point, even though the vendors, the integrators are saying, hey, look, we're starting to see shortages, we're going to be pushed out, the clients are saying, well, we've got our budget that we have to spend, so we're going to go ahead and order it now. Yeah, we got to wait 8 weeks, 10 weeks, 12 weeks, whatever it is, but if we don't allocate it now, we're going to lose it. So there's always that last rush at the end of fiscal for companies and for integrators, because again, they're trying to get their sales, year-end sales with their manufacturers as well. But now, you know, I just received an email yesterday from one of my regional sales managers, 14 to 18 week lead times minimum on products that you need for projects. Not, it's not even more like little accessories or things that you can live without. We're talking about infrastructure parts of these deployment systems. So there's video conferencing, video distribution, audio distribution, speakers. I mean, just crazy stuff. And so the concern is that the sales are available. The product isn't, which then is creating a lot of difficult conversations with clients, which is, we'd love to be able to do the work. We have no inventory and we've scoured it. So now the choices are, do you hammer profitability? Do you have to deal with plan B, plan C, plan D vendors and completely deviate from what you do? Or do you wait? And then when you wait, well, if you know, the client's like, well, it's not my problem you don't have gear. And so I don't need to give you the money now. I'm going to wait until you get the gear and call me. And so it's a huge catch 22 that's coming on right now. And I think we're going to see, especially over the next quarter, you know, because again, this is all looking backwards, right? This is looking at past sales. It's not projected. And I think if you talk to Avixa about the projected sales that are coming up, I think we're going to start hearing more and more that supply chain is going to create advisories when in the forward thinking reports that are going to be coming out.
Well, I want to follow up with you for a minute on that, though. So you said like supply chain, we've been seeing mixed signals or mixed information about supply chain. Some are saying they're handling it well. Some are saying that it's a real crunch. But do you see the fact that a lot of corporations are now saying, like Google and Apple are saying, we're not going to have anybody in the office until 2022 now? Does that give some breathing room, or is it just delaying the inevitable?
I think that, you know, yeah, you've got Google, you've got Microsoft, but I see them as a subset. Schools are back. So you've got the entire ed tech category that you're dealing with, you know? And so, yeah, maybe things might shut down and there could be something that occurs to push things back to distance learning again. But as it stands right now, at least for this quarter, you know, there's a lot of companies who just live in this industry in ed tech. You know, government's a little bit different. Corporate, I think a lot of companies have adjusted already. I think that those adjustments have already come into play. I think that most companies have viewed and said, you know, we're going to have a reduction in on-site workforce. However, we still need some of the spaces when they are here, even if they're used. So, I mean, is it maybe breathing room? Perhaps, but it also does allow the companies themselves, the clients, to say, yeah, we can wait. You know, we're in no rush now. So, you know, Avixa's, the statement was, you know, sales were great in that period. Started seeing the petering down. I think we're good. And it's not doom and gloom. It's just that, you know, you know, everybody, what is it? Everybody has a plan until they get punched in the mouth. And that's what this feels like, right? Avixa had a plan, you know, on what they wanted to say, and then everybody got punched in the mouth again. And so we're dealing with it again. And I think that 3 months from now, looking back, everybody's going to point and go, oh, yeah, you know, this time period occurred. And, you know, I mean, government work is changing right now. There's been some slightly large news that's occurred over the past 4 days, you know, in how government is operating right now and the military is operating right now. And so, you know, there it's a big eight ball of sales confusion right now, right?
Yeah, I like that. I like that metaphor. It looks prosperous, you know, who knows? That's right. Well, Victoria, Rich mentioned that they're holding off on putting employees in and adding employees to the payrolls. And the same report from Avixa talks about AV employment being up, but still much lower than they expected. And this has been a recurring problem, and something actually we're going to touch on in some other articles right after this, about AV employment sort of just staying in the same space. And do you see any opportunity here to get more people on board and ready for what we expect to be a rush? I mean, despite Delta virus and possibly another variant in Colombia being problematic, shouldn't this be the time for companies to say, hey, I should take on a few of those people whom I think I can really build. And by the time the full wave comes, I'm going to have some guys ready to go.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, talking, you know, as Rich mentioned, the supply chain thing, I mean, our backlog is huge. And what's going to happen, we're going to have a tsunami of work once all of these products shake loose. And so I think it makes a lot of sense to start lining people up. And whether that's, you know, looking at like what we've done, we have an internship program with college graduates. We look at like computer science people and you know, entry level that are interested in AV. Another thing too, where we look at the live events market. So, you know, live events is obviously way down, but we are having more and more clients that are doing hybrid live events. And so we still need those skill sets of people that know how to run a mixer and run audio. And, you know, they have some people there in person and then they're broadcasting to a remote audience. And we're even having corporate clients ask us to build them green, you know, a studio in their office. So there's, you know, that specialty that we can take advantage of. And then there's a lot of other ways that we can be valuable for our clients at this time, even if we can't deliver product. And, you know, delivering product, right, is our bread and butter. It's what we do. It's AV is, you know, selling big black boxes, magic, you know, black boxes and making them work. But the integrators are going to succeed are ones that are finding what the clients need and where they can bring value to them.
Are you having trouble finding people to stay? Is there a labor issue with you guys finding anyone who says, sure, I'll sign on?
So I'm not 100% privy to that, but what I've heard, so I sat on a call, an NSCA call earlier this week, and a lot of integrators were saying they were having labor shortages, they're having issues with labor, they're having people who, you know, live in high expensive places and they want to move to a cheaper place and work remotely. But that company needs them in the, you know, in the expensive place and vice versa. And companies offering more money, you know, to live somewhere else and work remotely. So there is a weird juggling thing, I would say, with the labor force, finding good people and keeping them, and then also, you know, being able to line up people for when you have this next wave that's coming. But I've only, you know, heard through the grapevine. I don't know.
Thanks for watching the first story. To see more of the show, go to avnation.tv. That's avnation.tv.